Hello people of the world, welcome to Dr. Microbiologist. So, today we will be learning a really interesting topic, which is what are coliform bacteria? So, do we know the term? In the Gram staining procedure, they stain red. In the Gram staining process, in the first step we treat the cells with crystal violet. This is the primary stain. In the second step, we treat the cells with iodine. This acts as a mordant. In the third step, the cells are treated with alcohol, which acts as a decolorizer. And finally, in the fourth step, we treat them with safranin, which is the counter stain and stains the cells red. In the diagram, not all of the cells stain red or decolorizes because of the efficiency of the process. Next, they are rod-shaped bacteria. Thirdly, they are non-spore-forming. Do we remember about spores? We sure do. So, spores are highly resistant, dormant structure. Thirdly, they are non-spore-forming. Do we remember about spores? We sure do. So, spores are highly resistant, dormant structures, that is no metabolic activity, formed in response to adverse environmental conditions. Next, they may be motile or non-motile, meaning they may or may not move from one place to another. Coliform bacteria are lactose fermentators. So, lactose fermentation is a process in which glucose or any similar 6-carbon molecule is broken down into cellular energy and lactate, when present in water becomes lactic acid. Bacteria such as Escherichia coli can convert formate into hydrogen gas and carbon dioxide. Not all coliform bacteria can ferment lactose, therefore, for the sake of convenience, they are categorized on the basis of the presence of the enzyme beta-galactosidase. This enzyme catalyzes the first step of lactose fermentation. They are found in the aquatic environment, soil, feces of warm-blooded mammals, and vegetables we consume. Coliform bacteria are often called indicator organisms. They themselves do not cause much serious illness but indicate the presence of other pathogenic fecal microorganisms in the sample of water collected. It is presumed that if coliform bacteria are present in a sample of water, then there is the tendency of the presence of other pathogenic bacteria. Therefore, they are used in sanitation procedures of food and water. Thanks a lot for watching. If you have any questions, please comment down. Have a great day. Stay home and stay safe.